I got you.
So next we have John Gordon. Born to be a racer, Gordon's interest in high performance lifestyle sparked after witnessing a local dirt track where his dad in Illinois had taken him. So he saved up $43 and he bought a Ford two-door sedan and began racing dirt tracks for his college. He went to Clemson. After tasting the acceleration of drag racing, Gordon replaced traditional school with a five-day Carroll Shelby School of High Performance Driving. This gave him an open door to a job at Shelby American, even if he just started scraping floors to get his very goal. Starting with Lotus when he was 21, Morton went to Allen to race Carroll Shelby's famous poker team. He didn't get a break until 69 when Peter Brock recruited him from the VRE Dodson team. With a continuous winning streak, Morton won just about everything he could, including the 1971 Sports Car Club Driver of the Year, Dodson Race Car Driver of the Year, and 1994 with the Nissan team, he earned 484B at the Mazda Race Car in the same. Now, even after all these years, once a racer, always a racer, as all these guys will tell you. He still does a lot of vintage racing, Cobras, Corvettes, Porsches, and his signature Lotus 23, a lot of vintage races. And when he has time, he likes to go out and drive riding faster than his motorbike. And the last person on our panel, but not the least, is Gary Patterson, the director of FIME. Gary Patterson has been a key member of the team at Shelby since the birth of the continuation program in Series 1. As a key test and development driver for the company, he has been very involved in just about everything that rolls out the door. Now, an interesting story about Gary is his racing didn't start with sports cars. He was 16 years old. He saved his money for mowing lawns. Gary drag raced that car, and then he ended up in a modified Corvette. He's done open road racing, he's been involved in the Silverstein Classic, he's done everything from road racing, drag racing, as far as car racing. He also serves as a short-term supervisor for the Ultimate Street Car Association competition, and he's a drag instructor quite well. Thank you for being here, Gary. So we have a few prepared questions we're going to ask all the panelists. If we have time at the end, we'll take questions from the audience also. So I'd like to start with you, Bob. You continue to be connected to motorsports through your driving school. How has racing changed over the years? So, Hannah, they say there are two families, those who love the machines and those who would ride them like they stole it. Which would you consider yourself to be? Right, car, so I just like right car. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
history, and I like seeing the best that people do at that particular time, and then going out to Laguna Seca and trying to book it.
Originally, we were going to ask Gary Patterson that question, but we know what the answer is to that. Right, Gary?
No, I wanted to live to finish. Got to finish to win.
So, Alan, the spirit of competition has certainly gone bright in your career. Tell us about some of your most competitive moments. In fact, I think a couple of them included Bob.
Bob, are we going to let him play?
I've been doing this about 50 years and
yeah, that's right.
My father's Bob, there's Mr. Kyle, and the other one.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's good thing you got classes now. Anyhow, to answer your question, I am an incredibly competitive person. In fact, my motto is second place is first loser. And whether it's in business, whether you're selling corporates, or whether you're selling watches. Working with Bobby Mercy and a lot of fun because, again, their model is a spirit of competition. And so, bottom line is that, like I say, it's a second place is first loser. When I was building houses, I was racing cars, sure. You know, I wanted to be out front. And if I wasn't out front, I would have been out front.
Like I tell you, my years ago,